Hey guys, welcome to another computer graphics tutorial. You guys have been requesting this topic for a long time, so here it is, Bresenham's line drawing algorithm. Now, what is Bresenham's line drawing algorithm? Basically, it's an accurate and efficient line generating algorithm, alright? And in Bresenham's line drawing algorithm, what we do is, we use something called incremental integer calculations. Alright, so first thing we need to find out is what is the slope of the line. Okay, so how we find the slope of the line? Basically, this is the formula: delta y upon delta x, that is modulus of y2 minus y1 upon modulus of x2 minus x1. If the slope is less than 1 and is positive, then the algorithm is like this. Alright, so these are the 5 steps of the algorithm. First thing, input 2 endpoints and store the left endpoint as x0 comma y0. Alright, then we plot the first point, that is x0 comma y0. Then we calculate 4 constants. There are 4 constants that we have to calculate beforehand only, so that we can use it in the problem solving or the calculations. Alright, so what are the 4 constants? First constant is delta x, that is x2 minus x1 modulus of that. Then comes delta y, that is modulus of y2 minus y1. Now the third one is 2 times delta y, okay, and the fourth one is 2 times delta y minus 2 times delta x. Now this delta x and delta y, we need to use it over here for finding out these values. All right and these are the 4 constant that will remain always available for you during the calculations. Now the fourth step is to find out something called as decision parameter, okay, value of decision parameter, with the formula like this. P0 is the decision parameter. Its formula is 2 delta y minus delta x. Alright. So first we calculate the initial decision parameter. Alright. That is P0. And for each xk along the line, that is for every pixel position, next upcoming pixel position, what we do is we perform the following test. That is, if pk is less than 0. Okay. The point to plot is xk plus 1. yk, that is, we increment the current x coordinate by 1 and we keep the y coordinate same. And the next thing that we do is we increment the initial parameter, that is the decision parameter, with this formula, that is pk plus 2 delta y. Alright, so this is the step that you do if pk is less than 0. Okay, that is, the parameter decision or decision parameter is less than 0, then you do these two things. That is, you plot the point xk plus 1 comma yk, and otherwise, that is any other condition, that is, it is greater than 0 or equal to 0, what you do is you plot the next point as xk plus 1 comma yk plus 1. That is, you increment x and y both by 1, and also you increment the decision parameter with 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. That is, you add 2 delta y minus 2 delta x value to the initial decision parameter. Alright, so let's look at an example so that you understand it better. Alright, so this is the example. We have to plot a line using Bresenham's line drawing algorithm with endpoints 19,38 and 28,45. Alright, now this is the solution. First thing what we have learned, that we have to find out the slope. Now slope is y2 minus y1. Okay, that is 45 minus 38. Okay, see, this is y1, this is y2. So 45 minus 38, modulus of that, divided by x2 minus x1, that is 28 minus 19. Alright, so it is 7 divided by 9, which is less than 1, and it is also positive. Alright, so slope is less than 1 and is positive. So let's calculate the 4 constants now using this algorithm. Now what are the 4 constants that we discussed? First one is delta x. Now delta x is x2 minus x1. Now what is x2? x2 is 28 and x1 is 19. Alright, so you subtract 19 from 28, you get 9. What is delta y? Modulus of y2 minus y1, that is 45 minus 38, you get 7. Alright, so we have found the first two constants. The next two constants are 2 delta y, that is, multiply delta y by 2, you get 14. And the next one is 2 delta y minus 2 delta x, that is 14 minus 18. So 14 minus 18, you get minus 4. All right. Now we have found out the four constants. Now let's get started with finding the initial parameter, decision parameter. What is the initial decision parameter? P0 is equal to 2 delta y minus delta x. That is the formula over here. Okay. 2 delta y minus delta x. Now what is 2 delta y? 2 delta y is 14 and delta x is 9. 14 minus 9 is 5. All right. Now let's perform the test. Is P0 less than 0? No. So you go for the second condition, this condition, otherwise condition. All right. Then we plot the next point as xk plus 1, comma yk plus 1. That is 20, comma 39. What was the initial point? 19, comma 38. You increment x and y both by 1. So you get 20, comma 39. All right. And the next thing is you increment the decision parameter also. How you do it? You add 2 delta y minus 2 delta x value to this one. Now what is the value of 2 delta y minus 2 delta x? It is minus 4. So you add it to the initial decision parameter, which was 5. So 5 plus minus 4, you get the new decision parameter as 1. All right. So we have done both the steps after the test. That is, you plotted the next point and you have also got the next decision parameter. Now next decision parameter is 1. All right. So for next decision parameter, pk is equal to 1. Is it less than 0? No, it is not. So it is in the otherwise condition. So what you do again, you increment the x and y both by 1. So it becomes 20 will become 21 and 39 will become 40. Okay. And you also find the next decision parameter, that is pk plus 1. What are the initial decision parameter? Pk, that is equal to 1 over here. So you take 1 and you add minus 4, that is 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. So it becomes minus 3. Now you test it over here. Is pk less than 0? Yes. This time the initial decision parameter is less than 0. Now what you do? You just increment the x by 1 and you keep the y constant. Okay. So your 21 becomes 22 over here and 40 will remain 40. Also, you increment the, or you find the next decision parameter like this. Initial parameter is minus 3. You take minus 3 and you add 2 delta y to it. Now, what is the value of 2 delta y? Let's go and check over here. 2 delta y is 14. All right. So you add 14 over here. So minus 3 plus 14, you get 11. All right. Now, the next place is pk is equal to 11. Okay. So again, is it less than 0? No, it is otherwise condition. It is greater than 0. Okay. So you increment x and y both by 1. So you get 22 will become 23 and 40 will become 41. And the next decision parameter is going to be pk plus 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. That is, you add minus 4 to it. So 11 plus minus 4 is going to be 7. Again, 7 is greater than 0. So you again increment x and y both by 1. So it becomes 24 and 42. And the next decision parameter is going to be 7. That is the initial decision parameter plus minus 4. It becomes 3. All right. Now, again over here, the next decision parameter is 3. 3 is greater than 0. So again, increment x and y both by 1. So initially they were over here 24 and 42. It is going to be 25 and 43. Now you have the next decision parameter, that is pk plus 1. It is going to be 3 plus minus 4, because that is the value of 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. That is minus 4. So you add minus 4 to it, you get minus 1. Now the new decision parameter is minus 1. Is it less than 0? Yes, it is. Now what you do? You just increment the value of x. You keep the value of y same. So you get 25 will become 26 and 43 will remain 43. And the next decision parameter you increment with 2 delta y. Now what is the value of 2 delta y? It is 14. So you add 14 to minus 1. What you get? You get 13. Now 13 is greater than 0. So you increment both x and y by 1. So you get 26 will become 27 and 43 is going to become 44. Now we have reached the final x and y positions, because the next point is going to be 28, 45. Correct? But still we can do the calculations. That is, we can find the next decision parameter. Pk plus 1 is going to be pk plus 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. What is the value of 2 delta y minus 2 delta x? It is going to be minus 4. And the initial point is 13. So 13 plus minus 4 is going to be 9. So it is again a positive number. It is greater than 0. So you increment both x and y by 1. That is 28, 45. So these are
all the plotting points, that is 20,39, 21,40, 22,40, 23,41, 24,42, 25,43, 26,43, 27,44, and finally the last point or endpoint is 28,45. So you start from something like 19,38 and you end up over here 28,45. So these are the points we have written down in table, and this table consists of k, that is the zeroth first number that we are going to plot, initial one, after our initial point of x0, y0, that is actually it is going to be x1, y1, and so on till our final one, that is 28,45. And these are the decision parameter numbers that we have got so far. So that is 5, 1, -3, 11, 7, 3, -1, 13, 9. Now you can actually see over here, when the decision parameter is less than 0, what we do? We keep the y value same, but we increment the x value. Similarly over here, it is minus 1, we increment the x value, but we keep the y value same. So whenever the value of initial decision parameter or decision parameter is greater than 0 or equal to 0 also, what we do? We increment x and y by 1, but when it is less than 0, we increment the value of x, but we keep the value of y the same. Alright, so this is how we solve Bresenham algorithm. If you want more examples, let me know in the comment section below. If you have any doubt, please feel free to ask me in the comment section below. I'll reply as soon as possible. And if you like this video, please share it with your friends. If you have any other video request, topic request, please ask me in the comment section below. Thank you. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any queries, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. If you have any suggestions, please write them in the comment section below. If you like the video, please share it with your friends and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.